2011 was a year of change for the Cedarville University Lady Yellow Jackets, with two seniors, six sophomores, and five freshmen that are no longer a member of the NAIA, but not yet a part of the NCAA. This is their story, the story of the probation year.
Stand up and walk out on me. Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. I will try not to sing out of key. Yeah. Oh, baby, how do you
preseason is important to us for lots of reasons, and most we would all get and understand. But I think one of the crucial aspects of preseason is the bonding that a team does together and the understanding of personalities and gaining a grasp of how to handle each other. And then getting, you know, when you have five freshmen, getting to know the coaching staff and know what is expected of you. And off the court is probably more important to me preseasonally than anything. But obviously, we spend a lot of time in strength and conditioning so that when we start regular practices, we are able to go 2.5 hours and go hard and go full court because of the concept that we like to run and transition so hard that they have to be in shape. And obviously, what Coach Travis does, along with Coach Flunker, concerning preseason is very, very important. And from the injury standpoint, I think it's really important to get the legs in shape, get the wind in shape, get the upper body in shape, ready to go, because the season is grueling, and it's the preseason that sets the tone for that.
Preseason is super important here at Cedarville University for women's basketball. Just to build big muscles, get conditioned, get their hands on a basketball, have the girls get to know each other a little bit better, have them get to know us as a coaching staff, get geared up for the Packer season. Yeah, it's just really important. It's a fun time of the year, and we love it.
Well, preseason workouts, I can't say they were too challenging, actually. I try to fake I'm out of shape and that, no, I'm not as strong as I really am. Come on. So, just to make the other girls, especially the freshmen, feel better. But I guess it was okay. I mean, a little hopping and popping, but nothing too bad. Preseason workouts are really fun, but they're kind of over now. And we just did a lot of fun, like, lifting stuff. And Wednesdays are kind of the worst, because they're CrossFit. CrossFit means you have to, like, work really hard and stuff. So, yeah.
How is it different from what you're used to?
Last year I didn't do any CrossFit training, so that was like really different. Just like learning how to use all the different muscles in your body at one time instead of just like lifting and focusing on one part of your body.
Preseason was quite wonderful. I really enjoyed the workouts that Squirt made for us.
Was it difficult at all?
Yes. They were awful. I almost died, every single one of them. But I made it through, and I think we're a stronger team because of them.
It was intense, and Squirt's kicking our butts.
The trip to Green Bay was an awesome opportunity for us. We didn't play as well as we would have liked, but I think we learned a lot about ourselves and where we want to be and how we can improve as a team. It was just a really good trip. Touring Lambeau Field was a highlight. Getting to talk with the Green Bay girls after the game was over. That was a highlight as well. So it was a good trip. It was a little bit of a humbling trip, but everybody had a good time.
This is everyone on the bus. Doc.
Freckles. Flattering.
The trip to Green Bay was an awesome experience if you just take out the fact that we paid a lot of money to play a game. But other than the game, the trip to Green Bay was wonderful. Once again, you know, the building of family, the building of teams. We spent a lot of time in close quarters together. You got to see some personalities. You know, it was fun watching Coach Flunker be in her heyday and understanding that how much fun that was for her was fun for me. Didn't feel very good when we got on the bus after the game, but it proved to be a great learning experience for us. And being a Detroit Lions fan, even walking into Lambeau was fun for me. And I'm glad we did it. I'm really glad we did it. And the time of watching our players interact with Green Bay's players after the game and creating Facebook friends and phone friends and so on and so forth was really a part of what Cedarville is all about. And it was a great time.
And now we're in, apparently, the Green Bay Packers Fantasy Factory, where the hoops are set up at 20 feet high.
I think probably the next question would be, what do we look forward to for the season, and what's there to expect? And I think after the first weekend, it's very clear, we have no idea. It's just going to be, it's going to be an interesting journey. It's going to be extremely fun to watch, and watching them grow up is always enjoyable. 11 freshmen and sophomores with poor Kathy and Kara as seniors is going to be challenging, not only on the court, but we're a little emotional, and we're going to have to learn to understand being consistent in our effort and in our focus. But the journey is going to be fun, and the product that you see on the floor in November won't be the product that's on the floor in February. I'm really interested to see and watch the growth of this team.
This season's going to be an exciting one. We have just such a young team, and they just really are working well together, and we're doing a lot of things that we have wanted to do that has been missing for a little while in this program. Just transition-wise, we are transitioning really well, and just being a fearless squad. There's 11 freshmen and sophomores, and they just go out there and they play hard, and they have nothing to fear. So just getting better, using this year as a growing year, just going into Division II. So it's going to be an exciting year, and looking forward to it.